Welcome to this episode of The Law Show, part two of the 12 human rights that when breached, you can claim money for. 12 human rights, that's 10 plus 2 human rights that when breached, you can claim money for. All right, so in part one, we looked at six of the rights. We looked at right to life. We looked at right to dignity of human person. We looked at right to personal liberty. We looked at right to fair hearing, right to private and family life. And then, we looked at right to freedom of thought, conscience, and religion. Those are the six we looked at in part one. Now we are going to look at the six more fundamental rights that when breached, you can actually sue the breacher to claim thousands, if not millions, of naira. I prefer millions. Don't know about you. All right, so number seven, and I recommend that you watch part one of these 12 human rights that you can sue for. So I recommend that you watch it so that you can flow. But number seven is right to freedom of expression and the press. Right to freedom of expression and the press. This is provided for in section 39 of the Constitution. Section 39 provides that every person shall be entitled to freedom of expression, including freedom to hold opinions and to receive and impart ideas and information without interference. Wonderful. Wonderful. Thank you, Constitution. Thank you for this right. I'm entitled to my freedom of expression. I can hold opinion. I can say, I do not support the way of the manifesto of a certain political party. I prefer the other one. I can say I don't like the way certain institutions or religious organizations organize their school. It's just my opinion. I prefer the ones organized by other. It's just my opinion. I can hold political opinion. I can hold religious opinion. I can hold societal opinion. I can hold economic opinion. That is my opinion. Then I can talk about it like I'm talking about law now. I'm trying to ensure that we bring you knowledge of the law, information about law, and nobody should interfere with this, my exercise of my right. That is what the Constitution actually says. But there are exceptions. As we say in law, no right is absolute except a few. Every right has some exceptions. Number one, every person shall be entitled to own, establish, and operate any medium for dissemination of information, ideas, and opinion. Like I'm doing now, every person shall be entitled to own, every facility to disseminate information, ideas, and opinion, provided that no person other than government of the Federation of a State shall own, establish, or operate a television or wireless broadcasting station for any purpose whatsoever. So if you want to own a television station or radio station, you require license. And the reason is obvious. We cannot all own television stations everywhere, radio station. Some are saying kill people. The other ones are saying murder all the people who are fine. The other one, no. There must be some control. But beyond that, I can express myself and nobody should restrain me from expressing my opinion about any subject. Of course, that doesn't give me the right to libel people or slander anybody, but you know what I mean, within legally permitted parameters. All right, so that's the right to freedom of expression and the press. So we can all express ourselves. Thank be to God for this right. Number eight is right to peaceful assembly and association. This is another very nice one. This one is provided for in section 40. Every person shall be entitled to assemble freely and associate with other persons. And in particular, you may form or join or belong to any political party, trade union, or other association for the protection of your rights. Okay, provided that the provisions of this section shall not derogate from the powers conferred on the Independent National Electoral Commission to register political parties. So that's a different one. So, you know, apart from the fact that INEC, Independent National Electoral Commission of Nigeria, can register political parties, you can join any of the political parties that are registered. You can join any association of lawyers who disseminate law information like this. We can form one and I can belong. Association of all those who use video to enlighten people on their human rights. We can form an association. I can join. You cannot come and stop me from joining the association. Association of my village people, I can join. Association of Christians who like wearing tie, I can join. I'm free to join. But for you to stop any person from joining an association, you want to prevent them from joining an association. Workers want to form the association to protect their collective interest. You stop them from joining it, you are breaching their fundamental rights, and they can sue you for money. All right? Okay, I'm sure that is simple enough. The next one is right to freedom of movement. Section 41, right to freedom of movement. Okay, every citizen of Nigeria is entitled to move freely throughout Nigeria and to reside in any part thereof. I can move from Lagos to Jos or to Kano. You can come, you are now someone who can live in Igbo land. The Igbos can live in the north. Then the Yorubas can live in the south. The Kanuris can live, you know, everybody can live anywhere. Okay? To reside in any part thereof. And no citizen of Nigeria shall be expelled from Nigeria or refuse entry thereto. Okay? So, of course, so this is simple enough. Anybody can live anywhere, move around anywhere. You know, I can decide, okay, I want to travel to Lagos, or I want to travel from Lagos to Abuja, or I want to travel from Abuja to Kano. I'm free to go. You are also free to go. Okay, so unless there is any court order or there's a restriction because of a crime committed by that person. Okay, so that is the only exception. Otherwise, everybody, you are free to travel, man, within Nigeria. And Nigeria, as you know, is a big place, extremely large, mammoth, gargantuan. Oh, it's big English. I don't want to be speaking big English on this show. Okay, so next one, we're looking at the 12 human rights that when breached you can claim for. And this is part two. Okay. The next one is number 9, right to freedom from discrimination. Right? Yeah. Right to freedom from discrimination. And if you are writing, this is section 42, subsection 1, right to freedom from discrimination. I can read that. A citizen of Nigeria, of a particular community, ethnic group, place of origin, sex, religion, or political opinion shall not, by reason only that he is such a person, be subjected to discrimination. Let us put it, you know. You can't subject one person because he's a female. You know, you are employing people. You now decide to employ only male. You don't employ her because she's a woman. No. Or you are employing people. Say, the man applies for a job. Say, where are you from? He say, I'm an Igbo man. He say, no, we don't employ Igbos in this, I don't employ Igbos. Go away. No, not at all. Not at all, okay? Or you are employing people, or you are in a hospital. The man comes for treatment. Help me, help my wife. You say, which political party do you belong to? He say, I'm a so-so-so political party. Say, no. I'm the chief medical director here. We will not help your wife because you do not belong to our political party. Say no. So you must not discriminate against people by reason of their belonging to a particular community, ethnic group, place of origin, sex, religion, or political opinion. In other words, allow people the freedom to hold their opinion. Allow them wherever they come from. You must believe that you can get an Hausa man who can do work just like you can get an Igbo man. You can also get a Benin man who can do work just like you can get a Yoruba man. So that treats everybody equally. When you discriminate against people of a particular ethnic group or belief or sex or origin, tribal origin or etc., you have breached their fundamental rights, and if they sue you, you will pay very, very heavily for it. And if your rights have been infringed because of where you come from, you now know that it's a breach of your fundamental rights. And if you sue the person, you can actually get a lot of money. All right, money makes the world go round. They say money is a woman's best friend. How do they say it? So you can actually sue for a lot of money. All right, is that discriminatory? Money is not just a woman's best friend, it's the best friend of everybody. I'm sure men also like a lot of money. Okay, so the next one, number 10, right to freedom from discrimination. And this is provided for in section 42 of the 1999 Constitution. I think what the appropriate thing to do at this point is to take a short break, and I'll be right back and we will continue. But if you have not subscribed to our Pinnacle TV YouTube channel, you need to do so, so that, and then click the notification bell so that anytime we post videos like this, you will be the first to be notified. And you can decide whether you want to watch, whether you don't want to watch, or whether you want to watch it later, or whether, you know, or whatever, anytime you want to watch it, but you'll be notified. Then, also, you leave us some comments. Let's know you pass by. Give us a thumbs up and share the video. If you are a law student and you are watching, you ought to share the video amongst, you know, your law students, WhatsApp groups, or so that you know other people can benefit, you know, from it. I think that's what we'll do. So we'll do a short break and I will be right back.
24 hours, 7 days a week. You can find your favorite program, Law and You, only on Pinnacle TV.
Alright, so now we're looking at number 11 rights. Right to acquire and own immovable property anywhere in Nigeria. Alright, right to acquire and own immovable landed property anywhere in Nigeria, which means, you know, any Nigerian can own land. You can own land anywhere in Nigeria. You can go to Bayelsa and buy land. You can go to Ikotekmene and buy land. You can go to Lagos, buy land. Nobody should refuse to sell you land because you are not from their tribe. Or say, no, we don't allow these people to buy land here. So anybody can own land in any part of Nigeria. That's provided for in section 43. I'll just read it briefly. Subject to the provisions of this constitution, every citizen of Nigeria shall have the right to acquire and own immovable property anywhere in Nigeria. So that's simple enough. Anybody can own property anywhere in Nigeria. And if somebody wants to own property in your community and you say, no, he cannot own property, why did you sell land to him? Go and collect your money back. Don't you know that man is an Hausa man, a Yoruba man, an Igbo man, a Kanuri man, whatever man, whatever tribe is from. Don't go and collect the money back. And then, you know, that happens, that's a breach of fundamental right. Very serious breach. Okay, so we've done 11. Number 12, the final one, is right against compulsory acquisition of property. Right against compulsory acquisition of property. Section 44, subsection 1. I can read it. It's very interesting. No movable property or any interest in an immovable property shall be taken possession of compulsorily, and no right over or interest in any such property shall be acquired compulsorily in any part of Nigeria, except in the manner and for the purposes prescribed by law, that among other things requires you must pay compensation, you must give to any person claiming such compensation a right of access for the determination of his interest in the property and the amount of compensation payable to a court of law or tribunal. Okay, so what it means is no government should just take over any person's property. No person, because you are a big man and you like that man's land, you just take the small man's land. You cannot do it. The Constitution says you should not, you cannot do it. If you do it, you'll be in breach of the fundamental right. So the only way you can do it is if the law, there's a statute that allows you to do it. For example, state governments are allowed, you know, federal government is allowed to designate some property, maybe they can use it for public purpose, overriding public interest for the benefit of all of us. So that one is understandable. You know, they need land to build a hospital, they need land to build a stadium, they need land to build school, to house army barracks, you know, whatever. They need university, they can acquire land. But the law says you should provide compensation to the person who owns it, and there must be some opportunity. If the compensation you are offering is very low, for it to be adjudicated by high court. So you should not deprive the person of his right to compensation and of the compensation that is payable, the adequacy of it to be determined, you know, by a court. Beyond that, you cannot just take over somebody's property. Property I inherited from my father. You just come and take it and say, because you are a very big man, and you just take it by force. The law says, the Constitution says you cannot do that. If you try it, it will be a breach of the person's right, and that person can sue you for enough money. So these are the 12 rights that we have looked at. We'll just do a brief recap. The 12 rights that you can actually sue for, if they are breached, you can sue for and you know, make some money. So they are right to life. Number one. Number two, right to dignity of human person. Number three, right to personal liberty. Number four, right to fair hearing. Number five, right to private and family life. Number six, right to freedom of thought, conscience, and religion. Number seven, right to freedom of expression and the press. Number eight, right to peaceful assembly and association. Number nine, right to freedom of movement. Number 10, right to freedom from discrimination. Number 11, right to acquire and own immovable property anywhere in Nigeria. And number 12, right against compulsory acquisition of property. These are the 12 rights, 10 plus 2 rights, that if they are breached, you can sue and you can make a lot of money from the judicial process against the people who are breaching or who breached your rights. So that's how it's been on today's episode of The Law Show. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.
24 hours, 7 days a week. You can find your favorite program, Law and You, only on Pinnacle TV.